But the big fish don't swim in the shallow. And the problem is that we have so many deep Christians. Go on, help me in here. We know everything about everything. Come on, y'all, talk back to me again. Listen. Can I help y'all right here? One question. Let me ask y'all this. With our deep self. When God saw the stars in the sky, did he ask you? I wait. When God put man to sleep and breathe, come on, help me, huh? And pulled a rib from man and made woman, did he ask you? When God stirred the earth with wall-to-wall carpet and painted it green and called it grass, did he ask you anything? Come on, help me in here. When God swung the moon in a perfect pitch position so we wouldn't freeze and hang the sun so far that we wouldn't burn up, did he ask you? I wait. But we're so smart, that oftentimes we overthink our own self. Are you in here? Just because you have understanding does not mean you have wisdom. And just because you're old don't mean you have wisdom. Your wisdom comes based off of your experience. As you grow older, Lord, that's how the old ought to teach the young, based off of what experience. Watch this. My faith allows me to see through a different set of eyes. Verse 4. He says, "Lunch out." Peter, get this net from this water. Same water. But you need depth. Uh-huh. And I paint this beautiful picture for you. We probably, if we keep doing what we've always been doing, we'll keep getting what we've always got. Amen. Now we say it ain't bad, but that's hard. That's a tough pill for some of us to swallow. Because we like doing what we've always been doing. And everybody in the church, listen, everybody in the church who wants church to grow say amen. Guess what that means? That means that you cannot grow and be comfortable at the same time. So he says, lunge out into the deep. Where's out? I'm done. Where's out? Out is far or so far from my sight that I can't see. The problem is that we're so used to seeing that we feel like we need to see everything with our noses out. But Jesus told Peter, launch out. In other words, I need you to go so far out that when the nets drop into the water, you don't have a choice but to trust that I'm going to do exactly what I said I'm going to do. So here we are, New Providence. Caught between fact and faith. The question is, will you believe what you see or will you believe what he said? Y'all don't know when to say amen. Will you hope? Whose report will you believe? God said, as the earth is his and the fullness thereof, God said that I can have it because he owns it. And God said, by his stripes I'm healed. Why don't I always look like what I'm going through? Why don't I always act like I'm a defeated individual? And so, he says, launch out into the deep. Because when I launch out into the deep, the depth of the water is dependent on the bigness, or the size size of the fish.
Yeah.
We want big fish,
yeah,
but we're scared to launch out.
Yeah.
God have mercy. We want growth, but we don't want our faith to be tested.
Yeah.
And sometimes God has to stretch, has to test your faith to graduate you to a place where you've never been before.
Yeah.
And then Jesus shows up at Calvary.
Yes, yes, he did. Come on, preacher.
His faith,
yeah,
was tested.
Yes, uh-huh.
As a matter of fact, he had given his own mama a lesson. Listen, mother, I must be about my father's business.
Yeah.
In other words, my father has given me instructions. And there are some things that my daddy told me. Listen, y'all. There are some things that my daddy shared with me that I cannot afford to get knocked off course. And so as a consequence, as a result, they put a heavy cross on his shoulder. And
yeah,
that's what he did. He stayed the course.
Yeah.
They marched him up Calvary's hill. They lifted him high, dropped him low. He hung his head on the locks of his shoulder.
Yeah.
And took him down off the cross. Buried him in a borrowed tomb, but 3 days later, he got up,
yeah,
with all power in his hand.
Yeah.
So now what seemed or started as a hopeless situation,
yeah,
he stirred up my hope.
Yeah.
But you can't see it because you're still looking through your eyes. You see a small church, I see something greater. Come on, help me. You see red in a pew, I see pews full. You see the glass half empty, I see the glass all the way full. Come on, help me in here. There is no secret. All you have to do is step out on what come and knock on your finger. Faith is taking the first step even when I cannot see the entire staircase. All God wants you to do is step out on faith. And then as always, the great question of the house is, you say you want it. How bad? Do you really want it? Or are you so comfortable that you feel as though God can't take you to the next step? Have you peaked out on your learning? Do you know everything? What lessons are there for me to learn? God, what is it that you would have me to do? Because at the end of the day, all of us should have one word that is engraven, interwoven in our DNA. Nevertheless. Nevertheless. Every head is bowed and eyes closed. God, thank you for this word. Thank you, God, for your power. Thank you for your strength. As every head is bowed and eyes closed, there may be someone in this building. If you're here, you can give Christ your life. Here in this building,